My research question is something that's really close to me. I wanted to become, I aspired to become an OBGYN, and I came from a very small community. So my research question was, how easy is it for women in rural communities to access a healthcare provider or an OBGYN? And so I found that an OBGYN is a very important part of women's healthcare. But is everyone able to access their healthcare? Studies from the distribution of the American Congress of Obstetrician and Gynecology found that approximately half of the 3,143 U.S. counties lack a single OBGYN. These counties were located in the Central and Mountain West regions. Coming from a small town myself, healthcare providers are an hour to an hour and a half away, which makes seeing a provider on a regular basis a really hard thing to do. While accessing a healthcare provider is difficult, insurance is also a barrier for women. The U.S. Women's Health Policy in the U.S. states that women in the U.S. are more likely to be covered by health insurance as a dependent. So when a woman becomes divorced, widowed, or their spouse loses a job, they're more likely to lose their health insurance. Losing health insurance can cause women to use fewer preventive services. Women from rural communities are not always supported in health insurance. Some of my friends even don't have health insurance because it's too expensive. 48.6 million people in the U.S. lacked health insurance in 2011. Now, if health insurance was less expensive, do you think women would have more access to an OBGYN? Going outside the United States, a study done in Central America found that if women in impoverished countries had access to inexpensive or free healthcare, it would greatly improve their overall health. Current women's health reviews also talks about how local health education programs are needed and that any improvements in the healthcare system would significantly improve the health statistics for these countries. Another impactful thing in women's health is the fact that women are the healthcare decision makers for their families, as stated in Women as Healthcare Decision Makers. Women make approximately 80% of the healthcare decisions for their families. Some women have so many responsibilities that they have to take time off of work, or have flexible schedules in order to take care of their families. Women also do tend to have a higher percentage of taking care of their parents, any grandparents, and older people in their lives. In a rural, low-income community, women, they can't afford to do that. Women may also have access to health care, but it might not be as accessible. Diagnosing Disparities in Health Insurance for Women talks about how women use and need more health care than men. So, if women need more health care than men, women in rural communities are not keeping themselves 100% healthy like they should be. This can lead to cancers and other diagnoses which will get missed. But is insurance and low income the only thing that is keeping rural women from seeing their health care provider? Another study showed that in rural areas, healthcare was based on cultural and financial constraints. Rural communities have more of a friendly-slash-neighborhood relationship, and they often feel their patient-slash-doctor confidentiality would be broken. Barriers are set up in rural communities, as a study exposing some important barriers to healthcare access in rural USA talks about. So we should ask ourselves, is access to healthcare easy for rural communities? Growing up in a town of less than 500 people, healthcare is really hard to keep up on. Nurses do drive out to give vaccines and annual checkups, but other than that, healthcare is hard to get to. Personally, I have never seen an OBGYN yet, and I probably should. But in my opinion, healthcare checkups they're just given up in rural communities. The time and money spent to go see a provider is too expensive for some around the area. They'd much rather go and work their butts off on the ranch than go and actually see somebody. They'd much rather keep the secrets of them being sick or not getting the healthcare they need than actually going and doing what they should be doing. So, my questions to you is, how do we fix it? Or can we ever fix it? Let me know.